Hi guys, this is going to be a special video on NCAA March Madness 2004. The question being, can you export the draft class from NCAA March Madness 2004 into NBA Live 2004? Those of you who are Madden and NCAA football video game lovers or people who really like the games know that that's been a feature of Madden and NCAA football for a very long time. It just recently severed in 2014 where you could export the file into Madden NFL football from NCAA football. So the question being, in NCAA basketball or NCAA March Madness, either one, can you export the files to the NBA Live equivalent of that year? First of all, you have to go into the Dynasty mode. You have to simulate it all the way until you get to this point where it says end of season, which will usually be for any team you select because they don't usually crown CPU winners or simulated winners in this game. So when you reach this point where it says end of season, it's going to give you a few options. Let's go in and look at those options. Now, as you can see, it says schedule. Schedule for what? This is the schedule for your off season. This is very important. Now you see the first step is leaving cut players. You select this, and this is very important. So you have to follow the steps that I'm going to show you. Otherwise, you'll just lose the file and you'll have wasted a good hour of your time, because that's about how long it takes to simulate to this point. So it's preparing the players that are going to be leaving. Some of them are seniors and some of them are underclassmen. And I should also add here, I had a big problem when this game first came out. When I got to this point, I knew that I was able to export the class, but for the life of me, I couldn't figure out how to do it. I figured when you go in here, you would hit the back button and go out to the next step, and that would be where you would be able to export the file. But I called the 800 number. Back in those days, they had an 800 number instead of the website, and you call that number, and you would talk to a person who was an actual human being, and they would tell you how to proceed on certain things that you wanted to accomplish within the game itself. Me wanting to be able to export the class to NBA Live 2004. So they told me how to do this. First of all, here's the wrong way. You don't hit the triangle to back out, because you'll get this option. You will lose any changes. Are you sure you want to exit? You hit no, because you're not sure. You don't want to exit. What you want to do is not given to you at the bottom of the page, the top of the page, anything. Like I said, I got this from an 800 number. They no longer exist. So people who get this game now kind of lost on how to do this. What you have to do is you have to hit start, and it will activate the export file portion of the game. So I'm getting ready to hit it now. I'm hitting start. And this is what appears. Do you want to export this year's draft class? And you say yes. Okay, it's checking your memory card. They had to have memory cards back in those days. And then you can see, enter the draft class save name, and I'm just going to enter draft class. You could name it something else if you wanted to. What's the point? Okay, so now I'm done. Now I'm going to save it to the empty portion here. And you can see it's saving the draft class. Now what you want to do after it saves the draft class is important. Because this was really your only point in doing this. This step is done and will no longer be accessible. Continue to the next step. You can hit no. Okay, if you hit yes, it's going to go longer and longer and longer until you can exit the game without corrupting the file. You can exit the game at this point without corrupting the file. I'll show you. I'm exiting in the game. That's why you see what you're seeing now. And I'm going to go to browser, configuration. Well, it's actually just browser. And I click on browser, and I'm going to go into the memory card. Now you'll know whether you have this file saved. And the first thing that comes up there is the file that I last saved, which is the draft class for March Madness 2004. I am not going to show you how to export the file into NBA Live 2004. I had another video where I did that. So what I'll do is I'll place a link within the description of this particular video for that particular video. And then you, if you want to watch, you can watch that video and learn how you work with an exported file and how you, what draft class did you put it in. You have to go into Dynasty mode and run the Dynasty till the end of the season, and then it's going to ask you the question, do you want to import a file? And that would be this file here, Draft Class 2004 for March Madness. Okay, so like I said, I'll leave a link in the description so that you can click on it, and if you want to view that video, you can. Or you can just, if you have NBA Live 2004, go into it, go into Dynasty mode, run everything simulated, simulate the calendar season till you get to the point where it asks you the question, do you want to import a file? And that would be this file. And it should use the same memory card for both NBA Live 2004 and March Madness 2004. Otherwise, it's a little hard to sync it up. Memory cards were a little bit of a pain back in the day, but they also serve a purpose. So save both files to this, okay? And that's it, guys. Hope you found this video educational and you also enjoyed it. And I appreciate your viewership. Thanks for watching, and we'll check y'all later.